Hello everyone, welcome to the new lecture of lecture series on network analysis and synthesis. In the last class we have discussed about the pole zero plot and how we can obtain time response from pole zero plot, as well as we have seen the concept of complex frequency. Now in today's class we will discuss about the two port networks, and in two port networks we will discuss in today's lecture about the Z parameters. So these are the contents that we are going to cover. First of all, we will see what is two port and what are the impedance parameters, which are also known as Z parameters, and what is the reciprocity and symmetricity, and what should be the value of the parameters for these conditions to be satisfied for reciprocity and symmetricity, and then we will see how we can evaluate Z parameters. So first of all, two port network, or it is also known as two terminal pair bhi bol sakte hain. Two port means the same, and it actually consists of four terminals and two ports, and four terminals or two ports. One port is known as input port and another port represents our output port. So what we do in two port system, we apply input signal at one port, whether at port 1 or port 2, and obtain our output signal at the other port. So ek port par hum apply karte hain apni supply, and we find out the response at the other port, the parameters, and we obtain the parameters of these two ports by studying the circuit. So if we have the knowledge of the parameters, we can completely describe our network, we can completely describe our circuit, because by knowing the parameter values we can completely describe our circuit. So these two port model is mainly used in our electronic system and communication system when we have to represent our system with the help of any model, like we have done in case of BJT. In case of MOSFET, we represent small signal model by using two port networks. So in this we can also categorize as passive port and active port, and which in case we do not have any source in our two port, then we will say it is passive port. And if we will have a port which has some source, active, which has some source, it is known as active port. So example, I have already said that electronic amplifier, in which we represent our BJT or MOSFET as an amplifier with the help of two port. So in this two port we describe parameters. So the parameters are, we have different parameters in our two port, whether it is represented by Z, Y, A, B, C, D and H parameters. All these are parameters of two port. So in today's lecture we will discuss about the Z parameters, or it is also known as impedance parameters. So Z parameters are also called open circuit impedance parameters. Why it is known as open circuit, we will see. So we have dependent and independent quantities. The dependent quantities are V1 and V2, that is voltage at port 1 and voltage at port 2, and the independent quantities we have is current at port 1 and current at port 2, which is represented by I1 I2. So the equation involved in our two port is V1 equals to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2, and V2 equals to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. So these are our equation involved in our Z parameters, where Z11, Z12, Z21 and Z22 represent the Z parameters of the circuit. We can also write in matrix form as this one, or V equals to Z into I, where Z is a 2 cross 2 matrix of all the parameters. So to find out the value of Z parameters, what we do, if this is equation 1 and this is equation 2, if I will put I2 equals to 0 in the equation 1 and 2, we will obtain the value of Z11 and Z21. So Z11 will be defined as V1 by I1, I2 equals to 0. So V1 by I1, I2 equals to 0 is, so you can see that this is driving point, because single port is associated, V1 is the voltage at port 1 and I1 is the current at port 1. So, it will be known as driving point impedance, because we are evaluating at the input port. So, it is known as input driving point impedance, with output port open circuited. Output port is open circuited because I2 we have kept at 0 value. Now, the next parameter is Z21, which will be equal to V2 by I1, keeping I2 equals to 0. It is the forward transfer impedance with output port open circuited, because two different ports are associated, voltage at port 2 to the current at port 1. So, that we have transfer impedance term, and because we are calculating output port to input port, that is why we have forward term. So, this is forward transfer impedance with output port open circuit. So, this so Z11 and Z21 we have obtained by keeping I2 equals to 0. Now, by keeping by putting I1 equals to 0, we can obtain Z12 and Z22. So, it will be V1 by I2. Again, two ports are two different ports are associated. So, we will get transfer impedance, and because we are getting the ratio of input to output, so we will get the term as reverse transfer impedance with input port open circuited, because we have kept I1 equals to 0, which is the current at input port. So, Z22 is V2 by I2. So, it will be driving point because single port 2 is associated, and we are evaluating at output port. So, output driving point impedance with input port open circuited. So, these two are the equivalent diagram in which by keeping by open circuiting the output port, we will obtain Z11 and Z21. By open circuiting the input port, we will obtain Z12 and Z22. Now, the condition for reciprocity and symmetricity. So, that we have seen, what is a reciprocal network? A network is said to be reciprocal if the ratio of response to excitation will remain same, if we will interchange their position. Agar main response or excitation ka ratio dekhu, to wo same rahega agar main response or excitation ki positions ko interchange kar dun, then it is going to be reciprocal. So, how we will prove our condition for reciprocity in case of Z parameters? So, this is the equation Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. Now, we are evaluating the response at port 2, that is I2 dash. I2 dash will be equal to minus I2. So, here we get minus Z12 I2 dash, because V1 is, and then V1 V2 equals to 0. So, this is Vs equals to Z11, and the second one Z21 I1 minus Z22 I2 dash. So, I1 equals to Z22 by Z21 I2 dash. So, we put this value of I1 in this equation. So, we got the value of Vss in terms of I2 dash. So, we will get it as Z11 Z22 minus Z12 into Z21 by Z21 into I2 dash. So, that is our excitation, and this is our response. So, this is our excitation and this is our response. Now, we will interchange the position. Now, we have applied the source at port 2 and we are evaluating the response at port 1, that is I1 dash. So, I2 dash will be equal to Z21 by Z11 Z22 into V dash. So, 0 equals to minus Z11 I1 dash plus Z12 I2. So, we will get it as Vs, or we get the value of I2 as. Now, we will put in this equation. So, we will get the value of Vs in terms of I1 dash. So, I1 dash equals to this. So, this is our response and this is our excitation. So, for reciprocity condition to be satisfied, the response must remain same if we have interchanged the position. So, this must be equal to this one. So, from here we got the condition of Z12 equals to Z21. So, where we get the condition of Z12 equals to Z21, that is the condition for reciprocity. Now, to find out the condition of symmetricity, a network is said to be symmetrical if input and output ports can be interchanged without changing port voltages and current. So, we will change input and output port without changing the port voltages and current. That is, now we have applied V1, the current is I1 and I2. Now, we have applied Vs at the port 2, but the current remained will be I2 and I1 in the circuit. So, this is how we have obtained a symmetrical condition by applying KVL Z1 I1 plus Z1 to I2, I2 equals to 0. Here we have open circuit, so I2 will be equal to 0. So, we will get the value of Z11. Similarly, we get the value of V2, which is Vs by keeping I1 equals to 0. So, Z22 equals to Vs by I2 by keeping I1 equals to 0. So, V1 by I2, I1 and V2 by I2 must be same for network to be symmetrical. So, from here we got the condition as Z11 equals to Z22. So, for reciprocity, Z12 must be equal to Z21, and for symmetricity, Z11 must be equal to Z22. Now, we will see some of the examples on evaluation of Z parameters. So, this is first example in which we have to find the Z parameters. To find the Z parameters, first of all, we will find out Z11 and Z21. So, to find out Z11 and Z21, we will open circuit the port second. So, that port 22 dash is open circuited. So, when we open circuit it, we will get V1 equals to, we will apply KVL here, we will get V1 plus 10 I1 plus 5 I1, because I2 equals to 0, no current is coming from this side. So, we will get Z11 as 15 ohm, and to obtain Z21, we need the ratio of V2 by I1. V2 is, because no current is coming from this side, so V2 will be equal to 5 I1, we get the value of Z21 as V2 by I1, I2 equals to 0 as 5 ohm. This is how we obtain Z11 and Z21 by keeping port 22 dash open circuited. Now, if we will open circuit the port 1, that is port 11 dash, terminal 11 dash, so we will get V2 equals to 20 I2 plus 5 I2, we will apply KCL, no current is coming from this side, so we will get 20 I2 plus 5 I2, that is 25 I2. So, Z22, we need ratio of V2 and I2. We got the V2 by I2 as 25 ohm. Now, V1 will be equal to the voltage at 5 ohm, that is 5 I2, get the value of Z12 as 5 ohm. So, this is how we have obtained the value of Z12. Now, the next question in the Z parameter. Now, in this we have a dependent source, that is 3 by 2. V2 provided. So, now to again the method will remain same to find out Z11 and Z21. To find out Z11 and Z21, we will open circuit port 2. Port 2 ko humne open kar diya. Now, we will open circuit the port 2, I2 will be equal to 0, the current which is coming from port 2 will be 0. So, V1, so 6 I1, now we will apply super node. Super node is the current which is I1, so 6 I1 plus 2 I3, the 2 I3 plus 4 I3, so we have applied super mesh in this equals to V1, super mesh equation that we have written. So, we get 6 I1 plus 6 I3 equals to V1, and as well as V2 will be equal to 4 I3, the only current flowing in 4 ohm is I3. We will get V2 equals to 4 I3, or I3 can be written as V2 by 4. Now, we will apply KCL at node B. This node per KCL apply karenge, then we will get I1 which is incoming to the node minus 3 by 2 V2 which is outgoing to the node minus I3 which is also we are assuming outgoing to the node. I3 will be equal to 0. So, by keeping I1 minus 3 by 2 V2 and I3 we know V2 by 4. So, we have put the value of I3 here, that is V2 by 4 equals to 0. Now, we got the equation in I1 and V2, we got the equation in I1 and V2. So, I 1 equals to 7 by 4 V 2 or V 2 equals to 4 by 7 I 1. So, Z 2 1 is V 2 by I 1 keeping I 2 equals to 0, we get the value of Z 2 1 as 4 by 7 ohm. Now, I 3 we have seen, that is V 2 by 4 here. Now, V 2 equals to 4 by 7 I 1 and as well as V 1 equals to 6 I 1 plus 6 I 3 that we have obtained by applying super mesh equation. 6 I 1 and I 3 is V 2 by 4, that is 6 into V 2 by 4. So, 6 I 1 plus 6 into V 2 by 4, 4 I 1 by 7. So, we will obtain it as 48 by 7. So, we have obtained Z 1 1 which is the ratio of V 1 by I 1 and we have put I 2 equals to 0 as 48 by 7 ohm. Now, we will obtain next parameter Z 1 2 2 and Z 2 2 by keeping port 1 open. Ab humne is port ko open kar diya. Now, when we will open this port that 4 into then we will apply super mesh in these two mesh I 2 and I 4. So, 4 into I 4 minus I 2 the current which is flowing plus 2 into I 4 the drop across this 2 ohm plus V 1 equals to 0. So, this is how we have obtained the value of V 1 or V 1 plus 6 I 4 minus I 2 equals to 0 as well as 4 into I 2 minus I 4 the current which is flowing in this 4 ohm minus V 2 equals to 0 by applying KVL in this loop only we got the value we got the second equation that is in V 2 I 4 and I 2. Now, I 4 will be equal to 3 by 2 V 2 I 4 will be equal to 3 by 2 V 2. So, we will put the value of I 4 in equation this. So, on putting the value of I 4 in this equation we will got the value of V 2 plus 4 I 4 is 3 by 2 into V 2 minus 4 I 2 equals to 0. So, from here we got the equation in V 2 and I 2 7 V 2 equals to 4 I 2 and we got the value of Z 2 2 as V 2 by I 2 by keeping I 1 equals to 0 that is 4 by 7 ohm. Now, we are left with one parameter that is Z 1 2 we need the ratio of V 1 and I 2. So, this was the equation that we have obtained V 1 plus 6 into 3 by 2 V 2 minus 4 I 2 equals to 0 and V 2 we have seen that V 2 equals to 4 by 7 I 2 that we have obtained V 2 equals to 7 by 4 4 by 7 I 2 minus 4 I 2 equals to 0. Now, we have equation in V 1 and I 2. So, we need Z 1 2 which is the ratio of V 1 and I 2 and we have kept I 1 equals to 0. So, on solving this equation we will get minus 8 by 7 ohm. So, Z 1 2 is minus 8 by 7 ohm. So, we get so we have got all the values that is Z 1 1, Z 1 2, Z 2 1 is Z 2 2. So, 1 is 48 by 7, minus 8 by 7, 4 by 7 and 4 by 7. So, this is how we obtain the we evaluate the Z parameters by open circuiting once by open circuiting input port and output port by open circuiting output port we will obtain the value of Z 1 1 and Z 2 1 and open circuiting the input port we will obtain the value of Z 2 1 and Z 2 2. Now, this is another example we have. Now, this can be written as the impedance of the inductor is S into L. So, this will be S into L. Now, to again to find out Z 1 1 and Z 2 1 we will open circuit this. Now, open circuiting this V 1 V 2 will be equal to I 3 into S. The drop across this inductance will be the value of V 2 and V 1 will be equal to 2 plus S I 1 S minus S into I 3 S that we have obtained by applying KVL in this equation 2 plus S into I 1 S minus S into I 3 S. So, that we have obtained by applying KVL in loop 1 Now applying KVLian loop 2, that is this one, we will obtain our equation I3s into s 2s plus 2, that is s plus 2 minus s into I1 into s. Now when we will now I3s and I1s, we will obtain the relation between I3 and I1 from this equation. We will get the value of I3 in terms of I1. Now we will put the value of this I3 in this equation, so that we will get the value of V1, we will get the equation in V1 and I1. So, on putting the value of I3 in this equation, we will get the I1 in terms of I1, and Z11 will be equal to V1S by I1S, keeping I2 equals to 0. So, S square plus 6S plus 4 divided by 2S plus 2, that we obtain Z11. Now, V2S we have seen that I3 into S. Now, we need second parameter Z21, that is we require the ratio of V2 and I1. So, for the V2 and I1, I3 into S, and we have I3 in terms of I1 in this equation. So, we will get the value of I3 in terms of I1, get the value of Z21 as S square upon 2S plus 2. Now, to find out Z12 and Z22, we have to obtain the ratio of V1 and I2 for Z12, and for Z22 we have to obtain the ratio of V2 and I2. Now, we have open circuited this port. On open circuiting, I1s will be equal to 0. Again, when we will apply KVL in this equation, V2 of S will be equal to S into I2s minus I3s, and on applying KVL in this loop, we will get S plus 2. So, we will get the I3 in terms of I2 here. So, we will put the value of I3 in this equation. On putting the value of I3, we will get the equation I2 and we will get the equation in V2 and I2s. So, we will get it as I2s into S square plus 2s by 2s plus 2. So, Z22 will be equal to V2 by I2, keeping I1 equals to 0, that is S square plus 2s by 2s plus 2. Now, V1s equals to the drop across this inductor S into I3, and we have I3 in terms of I2. So, we will put the value of I3 in this equation, and we will get the ratio of V1 and I2, that is S square plus divided by 2S plus 2. So, this is how we obtain our value of Z12 and Z22. Now, this is another example in which we have to obtain the Z parameters of the two port network. Now, to obtain the Z parameter of the two port network, we have dependent voltage source here. So now here we will solve it with a different method. I1 is the current flowing from port 1, and I2 is the current from port 2. So, we will assume another current I3 is going in 4 ohm. So, here we will obtain I2 minus I3. Here also we have converted this by using source transformation, we have converted into a voltage source of having voltage 2V2 and in series with a 2 ohm resistor. So, on applying KVL in this, applying mesh equation for this, we will get V1 equals to 2 into I1 plus I2 minus I3, which is flowing in 2 ohm plus 2V2. So, 2I1 plus 2I2 minus 2I3 plus 2V2 that we have obtained using this equation, and V2 will be equal to 4I3. The voltage drop across this 4 ohm will be equal to the value of V2. So, 2V1 plus 2 into I2 minus I3. Now, we will apply KVL in this equation. So, on applying, we will get 2V1 plus 2 into I2 minus I3, which is the drop across this 2 ohm resistance, plus 2 into I1 plus I2 minus I3, which is the drop across this resistance, plus 2V2. This is 2V2 and minus of V2, which is the drop across this 4 ohm. Now, on simplifying it, we get 2V1 in terms of minus 2I1 minus 4 I2 or V1 equals to minus I1 minus 2 I2. Now, comparing the above, now the value of V1, we have the equation of V1 here and we have the equation of V1 here. So, we will equate both the equation. On equating both the equation, this is equation and this one is another equation, this one is another and this one is another. On equating both, we will get the another equation in terms of V2 in terms of I1 and I2. Another first equation we have obtained as minus I1 minus 2 I2. Now, comparing these two equations, that is equation 1 and equation 2, with our standard equation for Z parameters, we will obtain the value of Z11, Z12, which is minus 2 ohm, and Z21, which is minus 2, and Z22, which is minus 8 by 3. So, this is how we obtain Z parameters for this network. So, this is the book that you can refer for the evaluation of Z parameters and understanding the Z parameters. Thank you so much.